During the Cuban Experience workshop, the first part of the day focused on the body, while the second part provided food for thought. Professor Dr. Ruth Vermey gave lectures on Western versus Cuban style analysis and recognizing the meaning in the movement, staying in the moment, and participating in a dance dialogue.
So style you can differentiate. You've got the style of the dance, the style of the culture, the style of the individual dancer, the teacher. There are many fusions of style. So it would be a mistake for me to imitate or the dancers to imitate a Cuban way. They must always talk with their own signature. Their own signature is their personal style. They can be influenced by Cuban style, but you must never imitate the Cubans. You will be lost.
Maximilian Winkelhuis prepared a test from transactional analysis, which helped us understand our personality accordingly to ego states, our emotional states and psychological patterns in a different learning environment.
The Western people seem to have a highly critical part in their personality and an adaptive part. And on this island, we have met people very strongly adapted to the free child that just has fun being in the moment and a caring part that says, I'm totally okay. It was totally inviting, totally passionate. I would not have wanted to miss it for the world. I'm still very proud of what we do in Latin American dancing. And I'm also very happy of the ingredients we learned from here. No fear, no shame. Have playfulness and be okay.
My own lectures revolved around music and movement relationships and the specifics of Cuban rhythm and timing in movement. We realized that when body and soul function spontaneously, our instinctive and intuitive potentials take us to unknowable places where dance happens. We were also honored by the presence of Dr. Olavo Allen Rodriguez, whose lectures brought Cuban dance into cultural and historical perspective. It was through his words that we re-experienced how the various dances and instruments still popular today came into being.